Pe ambasadorul Letoniei la Chișinău, Uldis Micuț, îl poți vedea deseori în parcul Valea Morilor, împreună cu soția sa, Gundega.
Let's go!
Ambii vin aici după muncă sau în weekend. Tot aici i-am întâlnit și noi, într-o seară caldă de noiembrie.
So here is the place where you come after work.
I think we spend quite a lot of time here, yeah. Because it's really a beautiful place. There is possibilities for walking, for running, for lot of activities and roller skates to do as well.
And you live not far from here, yes?
And of course, this is very convenient. We live not far. We used to come with children.
Sunt stabiliți în Moldova de aproape 3 ani și s-au mutat aici împreună cu cei 4 copii ai lor.
How about children? What they do in Moldova?
First of all, they're following their parents and they are studying. Now 3 oldest study in school, youngest in home. After school, they trying to enjoy life. They are doing roller skates here around the lake. Mm-hmm. They play football.
In what schools?
They are in heritage.
In what language?
In English. They of course study in Romanian as a special subject in school. Mm-hmm. And it's really good because there is practical opportunities where to use this language all the time and they are helping sometimes us.
Did they want to come here in Moldova?
Yes.
Of course. You know, in the very beginning, before you arrive, you try to grasp the information about the country. We spoke about Moldova, of course, at home, and you know, the overall feeling, overall picture was positive. The first, you know, the first impression, okay, we go to another country. There are, you know, a lot of interesting things to do. Let's discover. And you know, this is the way of life, how we have chosen it. It's, you know, the routine of a diplomat of the family.
Pasionații de călătorii ne-au povestit multe despre aventura lor prin localitățile noastre.
You know that always when you go to the new country, there is new adventure discovering national food as well. And we found that the food in Moldova is very tasty.
What especially?
Placintas are there.
Placintas, yeah.
Placintas always help with children, also for ourselves, so different kinds of them.
You know, there is placinta for main food and for dessert. It's perfect opportunity. We never ever tried something like this kind of food somewhere in before. But of course, then there is Zama and
Mama Liga Kutahana.
Yes. And Asarmale, of course. Oh.
Am mers împreună și la ambasadă, unde Gundegan a povestit despre proiectul pe care îl coordonează, punând la dispoziția celor interesați cărți pentru gusturi diferite.
Here you can see some Latvian books, which is not only by Latvian writers, but even from other countries as well, but they are translated in Latvia.
Recent, mai exact pe 18 noiembrie, a fost Ziua Națională a Letoniei, zi în care letonienii marchează independența obținută în 1918.
Cum este marcată această zi în țara dumneavoastră, domnule ambasador?
I think we have to divide normal times and pandemic times, unfortunately. Normally, what is organized in Latvia, it is a military parade with, you know, some equipment throw off and some military men and women for the ceremonial parade. There are also concerts all around the country. Of course, main focus is on the capital city, Riga, but not only the capital, the whole country is celebrating. Of course, depending on family traditions, this is the day which is celebrated also in families, somewhere, you know, in a wider circle of guests, somewhere just within the family. And of course, fireworks. Fireworks on when the darkness comes in the night of 18th of November. So it is widely celebrated. We cherish as a society this day and independence as such, which we acquired 103 years ago in 1918.
Spuneați că se sărbătorește și în familie, iar dumneavoastră ați ales să rămâneți aici împreună. Cum sărbătoriți în Moldova?
I just wanted to mention that in Latvia there is really good traditions what we like, that it has normally take place in Riga, that a lot of people, all who wants come together, of course, before pandemic, and visit lighted torches in hands. They go from National Freedom Monument till cemetery for soldiers. And it means they're going through the Riga, not only old Riga, but it's quite a long distance, and it's so really nice look nice traditions when there is light inside in dark months. It is really nice family celebration because it's always connected with Latvian food and table and some Latvian songs in home as well. And we are trying to remember what was in this day. Kids are explaining what they know about, maybe about history. Maybe we're thinking about next year, what we would expect for next year for our family, for our country, how it will be.
And perhaps one more detail. 18th of November is Independence Day, but there is 11th of November. And that is the day when we remember fallen soldiers for these fights for independence. Because in fact, after we declared independence in 1918, it was followed with quite heavy fights for that independence to get it de facto. And 11th of November of 1919 was in fact one of the biggest fights for that independence. And so this is the day when we remember those fallen soldiers. So November is in fact very, very important months for Latvia.
But I think it's a nice tradition in family as well, because on 11th of November we always put candles in the windows. And I would say this November is a dark month from the perspective of the daylight, but in the same time, in our country, it's always full with light, with from candles at 11th of November, 18th of November, and for us it's quite full of light and full of hope.
Ați venit în Republica Moldova în urmă cu 3 ani. Cum vă amintiți prima impresie, acel moment în care ați intrat în Moldova? Ce v-ați spus?
We came in February of 2019 and, you know, we came by car, the whole family, and it was somehow the foggy, really foggy evening. And so, no clear blue skies, but, you know, just the fog around, darkness around. It was like, you know, this was the first impression. But, you know, the next day, when we started, you know, to meet people, first our colleagues at the embassy, already, you know, the first Moldovan partners, there was no fog at all. It was, you know, a clear picture, really sign of cooperation, sign of, you know, forthcoming attitudes for ourselves as, you know, newcomers. Despite the first foggy impression, everything what came after was rather clear and bright, like, you know, sunny day.
Dar îmi povesteați că v-ați rătăcit pe un drum de țară.
Well, I think this was connected with the fog. This was connected with, you know, missing the right road from the border, you know, towards the city. But nevertheless, we managed to came out of that that wrong road with some adventures. But still, you know, after that, if we compare, we can say everything went really, really good and everything went up.
And I would say that it was really best time to come, because in February it was dark, but after February there is March, there is April. It means the nature even helped us, because it becoming every day brighter and brighter, and then quite soon we started to see the first all the greeneries coming out and flowers. And it was, yeah, with every day we felt better and better, and it was really nice, so to see all this nature waking up and helping us.
În Republica Moldova, peste puțin timp, v-a prins aici pandemia de coronavirus. Cum credeți că a fost gestionată această criză în Moldova și, pe de altă parte, cum a fost gestionată în Letonia?
You know, I think, as experience, global experience shows, the pandemic goes in waves. So some, at one moment you are in a really good situation, so to say, somewhere at the low level, but then it goes up and you are at heights. In Latvia, currently, we unfortunately face big numbers of infections, and for that reason, the authorities took a decision in the middle of October to put in place really strong limitations, and there is emergency situation declared as well. Of course, also in the Republic of Moldova, we've seen also recently a spike in positive cases, so the figures are going up. I think there are no, let's say, fully ready-made elements apart from the vaccination. Vaccination is obviously the only solution which has been created to prevent the falling sick, so to have the COVID, or if you have the COVID, then the experience again shows that this is usually in a mild form. So I would say the vaccination is a key. Here, obviously, there need to be efforts, perhaps more and more, to convince people, to convince society to get vaccinated. I always think that, you know, important is your own example. So you lead by example. And, you know, I think every member of society, every person can contribute by getting vaccinated and by convincing his, you know, relatives, family, friends also to get vaccinated.
Dumneavoastră, cum ați suportat aici pandemia, restricțiile?
This pandemic came as a shock for lot of people. And a lot of people was not happy, and of course there was restrictions and a lot of people suffered. I think we were happy in family because we are healthy. We all the time are connecting, calling and speaking with our relatives in Latvia. All of them are vaccinated. We feel safer because we are not able to meet them quite often. In family, I think our school did very well, and kindergarten is this distance learning. For us, it was good experience and no problems at all. From one side, I even liked it because, you know, it was all family, all time together. Because before pandemic, there is quite busy. Kids are in school or in kindergarten. Husband is working all time in office. Afterwards, you have a lot of things what to do. And finally, it was like everybody was put on a stop, a little bit stop, don't run so fast. Spend more time in family. We started to play more board games in home or to do a lot of sport activities outside.
Movies together.
Yeah.
A lot of movies. I was working from home. You know, kids were at home, you know, learning from distance. I think, you know, every crisis is an opportunity, and we really tried to use that opportunity to strengthen our family bonds.
În această perioadă, Uniunea Europeană a venit cu un sprijin important pentru Republica Moldova, pentru ca țara noastră să poată să depășească criza provocată de pandemie și să-și relanseze economia. Care sunt planurile de viitor?
I think the key phrase, key word is solidarity. And this is also how we feel as the country member state of the European Union and the whole European Union as such. We wish to really provide support to our partners, to our friends, also to the Republic of Moldova. And I believe everybody can see that in practice with the help of delivery of vaccines, humanitarian assistance. And we as Latvia also did that in August of this year. We provided this batch of vaccines free of charge. Also, of course, by financial funds to help different sectors here in Moldova. There are needs, of course, health sector, and capacity of the health sector. Of course, different sectors of economy, especially, you know, those who are much affected by this pandemics, and here I can mention HoReCa sector. And of course, help and assistance to most vulnerable groups of society. For all that, you know, we as a Team Europe, we as a team of 27 member states, try to support and try to assist so that, you know, people can really benefit from that assistance.
Letonia implementează aici anumite proiecte de sprijin pentru Republica Moldova și care sunt următoarele proiecte pe care urmează să le implementați?
Development cooperation of Latvia with Moldova is certainly one of the biggest priorities also for the work of the embassy. Moldova has been the priority beneficiary when it comes to these bilateral projects, and since 2005 more than 90 projects have been implemented for the amount of 1.4 million euros. Currently, you know, there is annual grant competition, so we provide financial support for joint projects. This year in 2021 there had been several projects also supported. I can mention here the cooperation between the medical authorities, including also this here Emergency Assistance Institute on Toma Čorba, with cooperation with one Latvian medical authority. Also, we usually support elements which are connected with the media literacy and the fight against disinformation. Another area where we are looking at is the good governance and assistance to small and medium enterprises. So every year there are those projects, and we're constantly trying to expand and trying also to look at different avenues.
Credeți că se face suficient de mult, dacă tot am ajuns la acest subiect, pentru a combate dezinformarea în această perioadă atât de complicată?
We in Latvia were one of the first ones who started to talk not only about pandemics when it comes to COVID, but also about infodemics, which is everything what is connected, let's say, with disinformation, with misinformation, or with propaganda. Of course, with different information flows around and different opinions in society, it is a question of more and more these misinformation and disinformation elements coming into. We think that we have really good actors in Latvia who are trying, you know, to put forefront the communication perspectives, also the work with media. I can mention here, for example, the Stratcom Center of Excellence of NATO, which is located in Riga and which has good knowledge and really good experience into communication elements. We have also Baltic Media Center of Excellence, which is the regional organization focusing mainly on Eastern Partnership countries, including Moldova, focusing on media work, on the fight against disinformation. And we have also, let's say, a couple of projects in a pipeline together with them here in Moldova and with Moldovan counterparts. So we also try to contribute with our share into this, let's say, difficult and challenging fight against disinformation.
Care credeți că sunt perspectivele Republicii Moldova de a se apropia de Uniunea Europeană?
What we see after the elections in July, both from the parliament and from the government, there is a strong commitment towards reforms, towards, you know, making the country better, the system modern, more transparent and friendly towards, you know, the people, towards the society. I think this is the key to sustain, to go really that way of reforming and of orienting the policies towards the pro-European values. And then, you know, on this road, I am completely sure that the Euro integration elements will be closer and closer.
Uniunea Europeană a recomandat anumite reforme pentru Republica Moldova, în special în ceea ce privește combaterea corupției și reformarea justiției. Cum vedeți evoluția acestor domenii?
I mentioned this strong commitment by, you know, the new parliament and new government to put an emphasis on reforming the justice sector, fighting corruption, strengthening the good governance, etc. We see really, really good signs also in a practical sense. But I think my plea would be, okay, it's just even not, you know, 100 days since forming the government. And I believe, you know, these are very, very thorough and issues full with needs. So that means there needs to be some time given to the authorities. But really, first signs are encouraging. And I think this commitment is a clear sign that, you know, the political power is certainly for making the reforms happen.
Republica Moldova și Letonia s-au confruntat cu o serie de probleme similare de-a lungul timpului și mai ales în ultimele decenii. Letonia la fel a trecut printr-o criză a migrației, a emigrării populației, la fel și Republica Moldova. Este ceva ce am putea să învățăm de la Letonia?
What is important is to actually realize that opportunity for migration is not something bad. It's good because this gives, you know, choices and opportunities for people. If they wish to, you know, to go to another country, to work, to study, to live, whatever. This is a choice. What is very important for the country itself is, you know, to create the environment, you know, conducive so that those people who left are actually looking back and starting to rethink, why should I stay abroad? I better come back, you know, where my family is, where my relatives are, most of the friends. So creating this environment is very, very important. I think, you know, we Latvia, we faced that challenge of migration heavily, especially after accession to the European Union, when, you know, the labor market in another EU countries was opened, so there was a lot of people going for, you know, better salaries and work somewhere abroad in another EU countries. Now this phenomena is, let's say, balanced. Many people return. Still, some go and look for opportunities abroad, and this is normal process. In Latvia, we have, I think, achieved quite a good result in creating this environment, in facilitating or improving the level of life so that people really think not even twice but 5-7 times before they leave. And this is a key. And I think if, you know, such an approach can be somehow facilitated here, I think this could be a very, very good and interesting way forward.
Republica Moldova a trecut în această toamnă printr-o criză fără precedent în sectorul energetic, care vine din faptul că dintotdeauna țara noastră a fost dependentă de gazul oferit de Rusia, de către Gazprom. S-au făcut niște încercări, s-au adus anumite cantități de gaz din alte state și din nou a fost semnat un contract cu Gazprom. Cum vedeți dumneavoastră această problemă?
First important element is that apparently the immediate gas shortages are solved, so the gas will be delivered according to concluded contract between the Gazprom and Moldova Gas. It is also important that these discussions for several weeks, which lasted, showed, let's say, some necessities for, you know, finding alternatives, alternative gas suppliers, finding in other ways, thinking creatively what to do if really the crisis would not be solved. It is obvious that there are still elements on the table, you know, according to protocol of the negotiations, which is made public. So we will just, of course, carefully follow the further processes. It is important also to identify that that actually, and once again, these issues, energy issues, gas can be used also as a geopolitical tool by certain actors. Rather than, you know, put only as economic element And this is really a negative sign. In Latvia, we have our gas storages, which in fact, if you know something not foreseen comes, these are sufficient for the winter months for sure. And you know, for us, we are also working on the diversification of the energy sector so that we are not dependent just from one actor in the market, but we can, you know, have supplies from different places, from different countries, so that we can feel safe.
Care este primul cuvânt care vă vine în minte când spuneți Moldova?
Okay. Wine.
And vineyards.
Why?
Because when we're walking around, we can see that there is a lot of vineyards. And because of this physically, the ups and downs, it's really nice looking. And especially in winter time, when these colors start to come inside and these vineyards look beautiful. And there is possibilities to do a walks and to do the walks through the vineyards. For us, it's really nice and interesting because in Latvia, we don't have so many vineyards.
You know, we came to Moldova straight from Vienna, from Austria, from another posting before. And, you know, Austria is also a winemaking country. And we, in Vienna, we lived on the foot of actually Vineyard Hill. And we used to walk long distances there, you know, up the hill with a wonderful view over the Austrian capital city, enjoying those vineyards in all different seasons of the year. And we're happy actually that we found these opportunities also here in Moldova. So it's somehow connecting our, you know, life in Austria and our life here in Moldova.
Dacă aveți un poet sau un scriitor preferat în literatura românească.
One of my favorite ones is Grigore Vieru. I do remember still from my childhood that I have read, you know, also his poetry, you know, because
in what language?
It was in Latvian language because he is translated and several books are available in Latvian.
Aveți o sărbătoare preferată în Moldova?
Mărțișor.
Mărțișor? How you pronounce it correctly? Mărțișor.
I have also another, you know, celebration day which is quite close to my heart, and that's Independence Day. Taken together actually with the day of the language. That is the core of one country.
La finalul întâlnirii noastre, ambasadorul Letoniei și soția sa au avut un mesaj pentru locuitorii din Moldova.
Be proud of your country. It's really beautiful. It's a lot of things that can be offered, not just for foreigners, but for yourself as well. Discover Moldova and tell people, other people about it.
Also, try to contribute. Try to contribute to make the country better, more modern, transparent, you know, also in a systemic way. Try to help with reforms, with, you know, participating in the life. And then, you know, this is an effort for all citizens and inhabitants together.